In 166 days, Governor Christie will be out of office and back to the private sector. But our governor is not done making news. Check out this video. This is Governor Chris Christie at a ball game in Milwaukee, giving it to this fan who reportedly called him a bum as he was walking down.
Appreciate that.
What did he say to you?
There was a Secret Service right there.
What did he say?
I don't know, you wanna act like a big shot?
So the question is, what is the governor of New Jersey doing yelling at a fan? I mean, really, does he not have thick skin enough to ignore somebody that's yelling at him? But the most impressive thing here is he held on to those nachos. Very impressed. Back to our panel. You guys got to weigh in on this. I'm joined by Serena DiMaso, who is part of the county government in Monmouth County, New Jersey, and Jeanette Hoffman, political strategist, and Mike Donovan from Nexus Services. Okay, so you saw the video, and I looked at this. Now, Jeanette, you're a Republican. Yep. You're probably a fan of Governor Christie. I looked at this video and I thought, what a shameful display, what an embarrassment, how immature, how disgusting and grotesque. You've got a guy that was running for president in the face of some fan who, by all rights, has the right to yell out and say, hey, you're a bum or you suck or whatever you say.
Yeah, he has that right. I tell my kids this all the time. You have the right to freedom of speech. You don't have the right to freedom of consequences. So look, the governor, you know, he takes these things personally. We've seen him get into fights with people on the boardwalk holding an ice cream cone. He gave it right back to him. And I would argue this is probably good for Chris Christie's career. He wants a career in talk radio and, you know,
I think his poll numbers go from 15 down to 9. Serena, you're an elected official.
I am an elected
official. At what point should an elected official just expect, like a ball player on the field or an actor, that sometimes people are going to shout out, and honestly, it's not even personal. They're shouting at a public figure. There's a big difference than them insulting the vendor who's selling the nachos.
I think that people have come to a new place where they think they can say anything they want to anybody they want. And so if you come at it from that direction, no, the guy shouldn't have said that to anybody.
He shouted out, Governor, you suck. I mean, do you disagree that the governor doesn't suck at his job? Are you disagreeing that he sucks at his job?
But I don't want, I would not want, all right, 85% of the people would agree with that gentleman. I would not want to walk through a place, but then again, I would probably have turned around and said, been a little bit more polite. If I was going to respond, if it happened to me, I would respond in a nice way. I certainly wouldn't have responded the way the governor does, but that's what he
Mike,
does.
Mike, you saw this, you know,
and he said it from day one.
His son is standing there looking like, oh, Dad, what are you doing?
You're embarrassing me again,
Dad. Yes, I mean, as forgetting about the politics, I mean, look, I voted for the guy twice. I wish I could take one of them back at least. But I looked at this and I thought it was a disgraceful display of an immature, out of control man.
Yeah, he's a disgraceful, immature blowhard. He doesn't belong in any state house. In fact, he probably belongs in a prison house. This is a guy that I would support locking up. He's a wacko. He's out of control. Yeah, he doesn't have control of himself, doesn't have control of his state government, doesn't have control of this New Jersey. The only thing he had control of is those nachos.
He did have great control. But you said prison, right? Bridgegate, speaking of that, right? Christopher Wray, the attorney, the guy who has the governor's cell phone, top appointment with the Trump administration.
Corrupt, corrupt, and corrupting. This guy is as corrupt as they come. The people of New Jersey, you're lucky.
I'm talking about Christie. Christie.
He's the chief executive. He's responsible for what New Jersey has become. And, you know, we've sued him, and we believe that he is a disgrace in a lot of different ways. But this particular exchange was disgraceful with a capital D.
I can't agree with you that he's been a complete disaster from New Jersey. I mean, he's done a lot of great things. I mean, he was terrific during Sandy. He came to Monmouth County. He really did help us all, and he made sure that the federal government did what they were supposed to do. So he's done a lot of good for the state. He's changed some things around. Do I agree with everything he's done? No. But if we did, then it would be very boring. You wouldn't have a show.
He's a former federal prosecutor, and when he held that office, he was, of course, robust in his attitude. Like he is today, he is who he is. But he was known
for going. He sent a lot
of
crooks to jail.
He went after crooks, and he's become one. He is a crook. And
Jeanette,
my
how
problem.
How do you feel about that? I mean, that's a hardcore statement.
Let's cut down on the hyperbole here. I don't think he's a crook. You may not agree with what he's done.
I think he's a crook,
Governor. Okay.
We can agree to disagree.
Jeanette,
our
mutual friend, state senator in New Jersey, Joe Carillos, although he's not really talking to me now because I've labeled him Crying Joe, but that's another story. Aside from that, here's a guy that was so close to Chris Christie. I mean, a guy in his wedding.
Yeah. Yeah.
Won't talk to him now.
Look, a lot of people have a lot of problems with Chris Christie over Bridgegate specifically, over some of his policy decisions. But I don't think you can go and just label him a crook. I think that's kind of irresponsible. I think you're like the guy.
Starting tomorrow, we're going to have 165 more days of Chris Christie. There is no doubt there will be more video. So I'll have you guys back. Thanks for being here. Appreciate it.